Hello, my friends. It's Lady Jesus. How are you guys doing? God bless you all. I am in Torrance, California right now, just waiting on the Lord. I just had some brunch and or dinner, and I'm just waiting on the Lord for some instructions. You know, as a prophet, when God calls you, you go where He tells you to go. He told me to come to Los Angeles specifically for a reason, and I'm going to take communion right now. I'll take communion. Thank you, Lord. Blood of Jesus for the sins of the land, in Jesus' name I plead the blood of Jesus over us. I'm going to anoint us with the oil. This is almond oil, as instructed to do so by the Holy Spirit. I put the full armor of God on us. I gird our waist with a belt of truth, breastplate of righteousness, feet shod with the gospel of peace, sword of the Spirit, shield of faith, cloak of zeal, helmet of salvation, the mind of Christ, do the perfect will of the Father, as we're robed in Yeshua. Excuse me, seated in the heavenly places. I've got hair on my face. At the right hand of the throne of the Father, we're in Him, He's in us, and we're filled with the Holy Spirit. Father, I just thank You for Your guidance. And last night, and we're in the Father, the Father's in us, and we're filled with the Holy Spirit. We declare and decree it, that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. Every tongue that rises in judgment, we shall condemn, in Jesus' name. And that we will expand the tent stakes, in Jesus' name. We bind the principalities and powers and rulers of the darkness of the world over the territories we're in. Just be in agreement with me on that. We bind the prince of Torrance and Los Angeles and wherever you're at. Just bind that prince, that demonic stronghold over your territory right now. You're robed in Christ. You're in Him. You've been given keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth is bound in heaven. Whatever you loosen on earth is loosened in heaven. And I know the Lord has given me Jeremiah 1, 9, and 10 prophecy, that He has put His hand over my mouth to tear down and pluck up and cast out and to destroy and to overthrow and to build and to plant. And we are under Isaiah chapter 61, the planting of the Lord, the repairer of the city streets and the repairer of the breaches. The breach is the breach between man and God, and man. And God calls us to repair the breaches. And I am right now in Los Angeles under the instruction of the Holy Spirit. And now I'm just seeing that the Lord is telling me it's time for to pray for revival and map the territory. And last night, the Lord said to me to Queen Governor or Government. I wasn't sure. It's one and the same almost. And then this morning I saw, last night I was mapping, and this morning I saw the Lord say, I saw on Facebook and in media, on social media, that our governor has established a new restriction regulation against Governor Newsome in California, and the nations and people around the nation are laughing about it, because our governor uniquely in California has said that we cannot worship at church. Even if first he restricts our limitation to worship, even worse than meanwhile he lets everybody protest. Okay, you have to understand, as a lawyer, the First Amendment of the Constitution, I have studied the Constitution as a lawyer, and you know, I had to study constitutional law. I was tested on constitutional law even to be an attorney. And one of the things you have to understand is that the First Amendment of the Constitution gives us first and foremost the right to religious freedom. That's the most important right in the United States of America, to gather and to exercise our freedom of religion. And after that, you have speech and assembly. And then at the end of the First Amendment, you have the right to protest. However, somehow, the governor of the state of California has seen fit to make sure that our rights against religious freedom are hindered and not equal to the other rights, and makes it the least priority of rights. And he's done that in two ways, and I'll tell you how in a minute. I've shared that with you before. And I have this righteous indignation about it. I have a righteous indignation and anger, a righteous anger for the bride of Christ, because this is our right that was established as a fundamental right of as a U.S. in the United States of America. And I have to tell you, the governor has restricted that right, and while upholding the right to protest, which is inferior and not as superior as the right to religious freedom. Like I said, there's this it's a primary right, the right to religious freedom. It's the First Amendment and the first right under the First Amendment. And our governor has not honored that in the state of California. I shouldn't say our governor. As you can remember, if you've been following Lady Jesus on Facebook, last September, God told me to go into exile from California because of our governor and the laws of California that were going to restrict our religious freedom. The Lord told me that last year. He said, because I was a minister, he said, you need to leave. And I said, Lord, why am I leaving? Why are you telling me to go into exile? I've been a good girl. And he said, no, it's not you. It's this state. It's going into captivity. He said that to me about the state of California. And I said, you need to go into exile from California. And then that's when the Lord instructed me to move to Hawaii. And so as a result, I've been living in Hawaii, but he had me come and visit, and now he's telling me to pray for California as a visitor. And as someone who grew up here, I have a lot of spiritual authority here. I have legal rights here. As an attorney, I have a law firm that I practiced here. My license to practice law is in California. The Lord has given me these primary rights in California, although he's relocated me. And I want you to know, in the name of Jesus, we just declare and decree it. And so today, I'm going to be mapping a part of California. I believe I'm supposed to go to Santa Barbara today and tomorrow, or tomorrow. I'm just going to play it by ear. I'm waiting on the Spirit as to when I'm to leave. I'm prepared to go, and I'm waiting on the Spirit. And secondly, may or may not go to Sacramento to pray and intercede. I'm waiting on that for this weekend. That may be an instruction for the weekend. I'm waiting on the Lord for that. So that's where I'm at right now. And I want you to know, okay, so today the governor, and let me tell you the spiritual implications of what's going on in California right now. Let me tell you the spiritual implications of what's uniquely going on in California, and maybe in some other liberal states, but definitely in the state of California. And what you're seeing is that the governor of the state of California is operating under a spirit of Jezebel and an antichrist spirit, in that he is discriminating against Christians and people of faith. Okay, he is. And so let me take you back. What happened in scripture? There are a couple of stories that come to mind from scripture. The first one is, think about what's going on. The Bible calls us to honor the Lord in the Sabbath. That is a commandment of the Lord. Christians are called to honor the Lord in the Sabbath. And in the New Testament, we see where I think it's Peter or Paul who says, do not forsake the Sabbath. Do not forget to congregate as believers. We are to congregate. And if you see in the book of Acts chapter 2, the believers, all those who are believers, were gathered together in Jerusalem, and the disciples were gathered together in one accord in the upper room. So the disciples aren't just the 12. You know, Jesus had a lot of disciples. The 12 are the apostles, right? They're the ones who were sent out. The disciples were gathered together in one accord in the upper room in Jerusalem. And as they were gathered together, the Holy Spirit fell on them when they were one accord. And as a result, what you see is the Pentecost, and the Holy Spirit fell. And you know, the Lord has prophesied, I know he's prophesied through me, that in end times, we're gonna have a double anointing of the Pentecost. And that's what the Lord is contending for. So in order for that to happen, we need the churches to be open in worship and praise and seeking the Lord. Okay, so that's one. Secondly, historically, America has had church on Sundays, mostly some celebrate on Saturdays, to congregate together and fellowship as believers every Sunday, which is the first day of the week. And some people do it on Saturday. They're finishing out the week with worship, and others are starting the new week. Most of America, American churches are on Sunday. I'd say maybe 80% of American churches are on Sunday, and some have Saturday night service too. And I got to tell you, when they worship on Sunday, what they're declaring, they're gathering, Christians, believers are gathering all around the United States of America, worshiping and praising and starting our week with worship before the Lord every Sunday. And as we gather together on Sunday morning, what we are seeing is a spirit of Pentecost every Sunday, where the Holy Spirit is falling amongst the worshipers were gathered together in one accord and worshiping, and the Spirit of God manifests in our churches all over the nation and sets the tone for the week, for the whole week, for the Spirit of God to fall on our nation and to bless our nation. And God blesses the wicked because of the prayers of the righteous, right? And when we gather together, we're inviting the Spirit of God to come in and bless our nation. Even if some of us are wicked, they're still being blessed, because the Bible says, the Bible says that the Lord raises the sun on the good and the evil, right? So because for the sake of the good, he blesses the evil, right? And so God is, he's blessing us, and the wicked, people who don't know Christ and who are walking in sin, they get the outflow of the blessing that God gives us. He blesses the earth for the sake of the righteous, right? Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Iria rocha caria rocha ca. Lord, saying something to me. Thank you, Father. We just honor love. Honor love. Thank you, Lord. We honor love. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. So the whole point is that the Lord loves us and he wants to bless us. But if we do not have church and worship on Sundays, if we listen to what the governor is saying, first he said, okay, all businesses can have 25% of the people in their businesses. Meanwhile, protesters have no limit. They can go out and protest as they want because it's a First Amendment right. But I'm not going to honor your other First Amendment right, which is, I mean, we had thousands of people gathered together on streets, protesting, rioting, looting. No laws. Police weren't stopping them. Meanwhile, the churches down the street couldn't have more than 100 people. He told businesses can have 25%. But churches can only have 25% or 100 people, whatever is less. And so if a church had, capacity for 3,000 people, which would allow them to have 150 people in there, he's saying 750 people, excuse me, in there. He's saying, no, you still can't. You can only have 100 people max, no matter how big your church auditorium is, which is completely wrong and a discrimination, and not only against other businesses but also against the right to protest. And again, the First Amendment right is number one priority over the right to protest. So there's a huge discrepancy and not equal protection of the law here. We're seeing Christians are being mistreated and being biased against and discriminated against and not being provided the equal protection of the law. So let's recognize that first. Secondly, he put a gag order on us. I think it was yesterday or today. He put a gag order on Christians. He told us that we can't worship or chant, which is speak in tongues, in church. He said we cannot do that. He put a gag order. So he's like, even if you can have 100 people, you can't gather together and prophesy and declare and decree and pray together. You can't chant and you can't worship the Lord. This is a spirit of Jezebel. This is what Jezebel did in the Old Testament. She killed the Lord's prophets from worshiping the Lord. She killed, and the spirit of Elijah had to rise up and destroy the spirit of Jezebel and her evil prophets and her. And you know, he had to appoint Jehu as king, and Jehu went and destroyed. And you have to understand, in the Old Testament, when Queen Jezebel did this over the nation, a believing nation, and brought them into idolatry and killed the Lord's prophets and established the prophets of Baal and high places for Baal and led Israel into sin against the Lord and idolatry, which is the second command, first and second commandment. And so she was doing this, and so the Lord told Elijah to go against the prophets of Baal, and he did, and he won. And then secondly, the Lord had Elijah, then Jezebel threatened to kill Elijah, and Elijah ran, and God told Elijah, Elijah, I have other prophets available. You're not the only one. And because Elijah felt alone, and the Lord said to Elijah, I want you to go and anoint Jehu as king, and Jehu is going to kill the spirit of Elijah. The spirit of Jezebel. Sorry. Strike that in Jesus' name. As the lawyer in me, strike it from the record. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. And Jehu is going to kill the spirit of Elijah. I mean, the last week, the Lord has been having me raise up kings. Like Elijah, God told me to go and king two men He told me to king two men, and these two men are supposed to kill the spirit of Jezebel. And God is raising these two men up, and he's having me like disciple them in the spirit and in prophecy so quickly like this. I'm just on the phone with them 24/7, just pouring out the spirit of God in them, because they are going to breathe the breath of God. They're like Jehu, and they're going to kill the spirit of Jezebel in California and maybe in the nations. So anyways, I just want to declare that over you. The Lord's been, and another prophet said the same thing. I had been praying in prayer time for God to reestablish, raise up kings and prophets and priests and evangelists and teachers, which is a fivefold ministry. And another prophet said, that's what God's going to do. And I'm like, wow, that's an answer to prayer. We've been declaring and decreeing it. And God's been having me raise up prophets and kings. And that's the season we're in right now, because this is no longer time for prayer. Let me make that very clear. This is a call. This is a call of God to the people of God. It is no longer time for prayer. It is a time for spiritual warfare. There's a big difference between prayer and spiritual warfare. Prayer is when we pray to God. Spiritual warfare is when we are confronting the enemy. When Jesus met that man with a legion of demons in the tombs, he did not talk to God. He talked to Satan. He talked to Satan's someone who was possessed by Satan, and he talked to the legion of demons in that man to cast that those demons out. And people of God, sometimes we just send up these like peewee prayers, you know, oh God, please do this, God, please do that. And I tell you, when we're on the prayer line and the people of God start praying that way, the Lord tells me to tell them, stop telling them to asking me, stop, tell them to stop asking me for to send out the demons, when I've already given them all power and all authority. I've given them keys to the kingdom of God, and they need to exercise, instead of begging me and pleading me to do the work. The Lord's Father says, I want them to step out in their faith and use the divine authority that they have as my children to cast out the enemy from their camp, from their government, from their cities, from their states. And we need to be doing spiritual warfare and declaring, decreeing, and prophesying over the territory. And we need to be casting out the demonic strongholds in our nation. And so today, the Lord just has my heart. He has my attention, and he's just saying, he has my attention every day, but he's just saying that there is a time right now in California, in California government, for us to cast out the spirit of Jezebel. California, I see Brian Reeves. You know, if you've lived in California, if you're raised in California, you have an anointing over California. But I do have to say that demonic spirits are territorial, you know, so they are not omniscient, they're not omnipresent, they're not omnipotent. That's why God has me map places. Because like God is omniscient, omnipresent, omnipotent, he's everywhere. You can be anywhere and pray to God and he'll hear you. But demons aren't like that. They're not omniscient. They're not omnipresent. They're not omnipotent. They're territorial. And they're territorial because they've been given power and authority in that territory. And power and authority has been given to the demonic strongholds in California to have a governor like Governor Newsome, who is shutting the mouths of the saints from blessing California. So let me say one more thing about how that works, as he's saying you can't worship. So if we, first of all, are limited in gathering and prayer, and then two, now we have a gag order that we cannot worship together. And I, you know, I know he's using this quarantine as an excuse, but I got to tell you, in this virus for an excuse, but if he is going to allow protesters, thousands of protesters, to gather in the street and not have any say in the matter, you know, and not have any restrictions on them, and yet restrict Christians from worshiping, he's basically saying, let Satan have his day, but muzzle the mouths of the saints, right? Because when we gather together and we worship, we are inviting and invoking the Spirit of God and the hand of God to come and bless our territory. And in this case, in California, and he's saying, Californians, you're not allowed to invoke your God. You're not allowed to summon him to come and bless California. So that means, guess what that means? When Jesus said, okay, get this. This is what's going to happen. This is what's going to happen if Christians don't fight this ruling and this order that's being spoken of by this ungodly governor over California, this evil, wicked man who is the nephew Pelosi, Nancy Pelosi, the Speaker of the House. God's saying harvest. Thank you, Lord. He's saying harvest. Thank you, Father. Praise you for the harvest. Thank you, Lord. And what he's saying is, what he's doing, okay, so Jesus, let me go back. What Jesus said was, if a demon is cast out of a house, and that house is kept clean, Jesus said that those demons will go and manifest, and they'll go around, that demon that's been cast out will go around to all the dry places looking for a place to a new house. Remember when the demons were cast out of that man with a legion of demons? What did they say? They said, send us to the pigs. They needed a body to host them. They're looking for territory that they can live in, whether it's a human being, an animal, etc. And what did that when those evil demons, Jesus sent them into the pigs, what did the pigs do? The pigs knew they were too good for the demons. The pigs are like, no, we're too good for the demons. We'll kill ourselves rather than be a house for demons. So, but these demons look for a place to dwell. So if California had this place where, California was a worshiping state, we had churches in California that were worshiping, and now we see our governor restricting our spiritual worship. He's restricting us gathering. Now he's restricting us, put a gag order, he's literally put a gag order on us, not even to worship this way, but to not worship at all, And that's what he's done. And this is what he's done in California. This is what he's doing, people of God. This is what he's doing. Don't sit back. The church has a voice. We need to be the ones protesting. We need to be the ones hitting the street. Excuse me. As I wipe my nose, it's windy. I'm by the beach area. We need to be the ones doing this. And I have to tell you, we need to step out in faith, and we need to war. We no longer need to pray. We need to war. Then we need to give thanks, which is also to the Father, and worship Him, which is warfare. And when I say we don't need to pray, I'm saying it's gone beyond asking God. We not only ask God, we know God's with us. Prayer is our conversation with God. We never stop talking to Him. But it's come to a point where you need to take your armor, put on your armor, according to Ephesians 6. We don't wrestle against principalities and powers and rulers of the darkness of this world, but in hosts, in high place. We don't wrestle against flesh, but against principalities, powers, rulers of the darkness of this world, and hosts in high places. We're not wrestling against Gavin Newsom, the man. We're wrestling against the demons that are in him and are trying, that spirit of Jezebel that's in him, trying to cause the mouth of the Lord's prophets to be silenced. And again, that's why God had me leave California. So I want to encourage you to really press forward. Press forward right now in prayer, and press forward. And so this is what's happening. Churches, you need to meet, and you need to be worshiping, and you need to be praising, and you need to be putting live on YouTube as people are gathered together fighting against this law. Okay, you need to take the risk. And you need to fight this law. You need to protest this law. And part of the protest is your church is opening and still worshiping. Still worshiping. Hi, thank you. And we need to be doing that. We need to be pressing in. And we need to walk in that power and in that authority right now more than ever. We cannot forfeit our rights to a spirit of Jezebel in the name of Jesus. So God bless you guys. Love you. Let's pray together in the name of Jesus. Hold on, I got to do something real quick. Come back to you there. I had to do something quick. The Lord was showing me. So we need to be pressing in prayer right now. We cannot forfeit our spiritual rights, our biblical rights, our divine inheritance as a godly Christian country. We cannot forfeit our rights, and we need to step forward, and we need to march on as Christian soldiers, brave into battle. And you know, we can't be afraid of a secular government under Gavin Newsom. We need to possess and inherit our biblical right that was given under the First Amendment of the Constitution to the exercise of freedom of religion. And we need to be fighting this battle in our churches, in the courts, and in our streets. You have to understand, and recently there was a case in New York where the religious groups fought the governor and the mayor for not honoring their rights to religious freedoms, and asked for an injunction. And the federal courts gave them an injunction. They gave them an injunction they sanctioned the government. They sanctioned the governor and the mayor and said, you cannot limit their religious freedom while you're protecting their rights of protesters. You cannot limit the rights of religious freedom. And so that was powerful. That was a big victory in New York. We need to do that in California against our government. Our churches need to be filing for injunctions against our governor and saying, you cannot put a gag order on us. That's basically what he's done. He's put a gag order on us. So people of God, let's press in. This is the spirit of Jezebel. We need to be praying. We need to be mapping our territories. We need to be warfaring for us. Pastor Matthew Barnett, I was proud of him. He was shocked that this came. He said he thought this was some horror movie, but it's really happening in the state of California. So we need to be fighting it. All of us need to be standing in faith. And Lord, I pray for our spiritual leaders and our churches in California. You warned me about this last year, God, and it's happening now. You prepared me, and you brought me back for battle, but you put me in a safe place in Maui. I thank you for that. And so Lord, I pray in Jesus' name for all our pastors and our churches to not forfeit our divine birthright as a Christian nation and to have the religious freedom. And I pray we press on and march on and fight for that which is right in your sight, and honor you and be a house of worship and not allow the demons to take over California. So as I was saying earlier, you know, 7 times the demons will come to California if we stop worshiping the Lord on Sundays. Do you get that? If we stop meeting and gathering together like we did in Pentecost, right? That's why America's blessed, because our nation, our churches gather and bless our nation the first thing every Sunday morning. And if we stop doing that, if we start putting, you know, Jesus says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be happened unto you. Our weeks are blessed because our nation, the Christians in our nation, seek God first thing Sunday morning, the first of the week, right? And they're worshiping and blessing the Lord, taking communion for the sins of the land and their own personal sins, and repenting, and they're tithing and blessing the churches. And as a result, our churches, our nation is blessed. And now the governor of California said, you can't do that in my state. And if he says that, then now the demons will take over. The demons will take over. And that's what he's looking for, because he's son of the Antichrist. Has a spirit of the Antichrist. I'm not saying he's the Antichrist. In 2 Thessalonians, it talks about a spirit of Antichrist that's been in existence since the time of Jesus. And he has a spirit of the Antichrist, the spirit of Jezebel, the harlot. You see her in the book of Revelations. If you read the book, Jezebel, the harlot, the spirit of harlotry is in the book of Revelations. And many have that demon, and he has her. And she's directing him and telling him what to do and to destroy our nation. She's directing Nancy Pelosi and telling her what to do. And that's the spirit of Jezebel. She is. And so Nancy Pelosi's operating that spirit. Their whole, you know, that whole area, you know, that whole camp over there has that. I'm not saying her family, I'm saying that camp. And so anyways, we need to pray. So Lord, we just pray you strengthen the churches, strengthen your bride. I stand on your promise. Remember Jesus said in Matthew 16:18 to Peter, he said, you are Peter. You're no longer Simon, you're Peter, the rock. And on you, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. And the Lord, Holy Spirit, especially highlighted Jesus saying, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against her. And so the Lord is saying his church is a prevailing church against Satan. And so the Lord wants to help us prevail in these times. God wants to help California, the churches in California, prevail against the spirit of darkness that's coming against her. You are in a battlefield, churches in California. You are in a battlefield. And the Lord says he has built his church in California, and she will prevail against Satan. So we need to do that this weekend. We need to be marching. Those are our marching orders, to prevail against Satan this weekend and to press forward in gathering in prayer and worship and in having spiritual worship and chanting, which is speaking in tongues. Praise God. God bless you all. Love you. And you know, wear your masks if you need to. Use your hand sanitizers. Maintain social distancing. But honor the Lord, gather together, and do his good work in Jesus' name. God bless you all. Love you. This is Lady Jesus signing out. Lord, we pray for your victory and your favor over our nation, over your people. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done. And let us put on our armor. People need to be hitting the knees. They need to be mapping their territories and taking territory back for Christ in Jesus' name. Love you all. This is Lady Jesus in Los Angeles, California, and Torrance. Love you. Have a beautiful day. Bye.